Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to 5th-12th music program, spring program. Our first group will be the 5th grade beginner band. And we are missing some students. The flu bug has hit. Thank you. The next group is the sixth grade group. And I forgot to let you know that both schools come together for the beginner band, so choir practices, band practices, and then put together and have a concert. You guys also get this band. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ryan Salek. I direct the 7th grade band. Thank you. The high school choir and high school band, so I'll take over for the rest of the night. This is the 7th grade band. Looks like they're all set up. We have three pieces to play for you today. When they go from 6th grade band to 7th grade band, they start to meet every day, 5 days a week for 45 minutes. So these guys have put in a lot of work this year and improved a ton. I'm very excited to show them off to you. Our first piece today is Crystal City Overture. Our next piece, Prelude in Dance, is in two very definitive parts, a prelude and a dance. So about halfway through, we'll turn on the jets and take off. Uh-huh. The last piece the 7th grade will play for you today is a hopefully familiar classic to all of you, the Flintstones theme song. It does require some audience participation. So you all know the Yabba Dabba Doo slogan. When I turn, you'll know, you'll hear it coming. When I turn, I expect a very vibrant Yabba Dabba Doo from everybody. They're going to do it too, so we're not going to let them off the hook. But here is the Flintstones. An ever so short break to get the choir on stage and all these stands off, and then we'll be right back where we're. Thank you. Okay, thank you for your patience. This is the high school choir. This is the first year in, I'm not sure how many years, that they have been able to meet 5 days a week as a class. Last year, I had them 2 days a week in the morning from 7:15 to 8 a.m., which is not an ideal time to sing. And this year, we get to have it 5 times a week during the school day, which is fantastic. So we're going to start today with Adoramus Te. Shenandoah, our next piece, will feature Addison Criz as a soloist. So I'm going to set up the mic over here for him. Thank you. I'm just going to leave it right here. We're going to move on to Les Mis, a selection of Les Mis. If you're familiar with the musical or the movie, we sing just about every song in this medley that there is. We will feature Hannah Streisand as a solo on this one, but we hope you enjoy Les Mis.
The day I'm not the day older.
So one of my favorite parts of this group is I really am not doing much work up here. As you can see there, I conduct them every once in a while, but most of the time they're doing it on their own, listening to each other, which is way harder than it looks. So I'm really proud of them for that. We have two more pieces for you. The next piece is Stars I Shall Find. The choir is going to wrap up with one more piece for you, titled She Sings. Before we do that, the choir has one more performance. They'll sing a song at graduation, a very heartfelt version of Danny Boy. So if you find yourself at graduation, you get to see them one more time. Really quickly, I'd like to point out the seniors in the group. This is their last spring concert. Sage Petuchka. Kayleen Zach. Vincent Hageman and Ariane Lehman. So here's She Sings.
Thank you.
We have one more group for you tonight, and if you haven't already noticed, we have a little bit of a different setup on the stage. So it'll take just a few minutes to scrunch all 26 of the senior high band members up here, but stick with us. Was entitled Eagle Mountain Overture, which I did some research. There's lots of Eagle Mountains, apparently. I wouldn't have guessed. But that one was commissioned in Florida. I know there were mountains in Florida. Anyway, our next piece is Three Airs from Gloucester. This piece is three movements long. Traditionally, you don't clap in between the movements, so you can hold your raucous applause until the very end. But each of the movements is supposed to represent the lives of the peasants that lived at the Wembley Castle. So everything is very British inspired in this piece. The first movement is The Jolly Earl of Cholmondeley. Yes, it doesn't look like Cholmondeley, but you can pronounce that Cholmondeley. Second piece is Air for Eventide, and followed by The Fifes of Wembley.
Thank you.
Okay, we're winding down. Two more pieces left for you today. The next piece is Cumberland Cross. Very reminiscent of America. Feels very open. It might remind you of the Shenandoah Mountains as you listen. That's all I have to say. Thank you all so very much for attending and being with us tonight. We have one piece left. I'll talk about that piece in a little bit. I'm extremely proud of this group. They put in a lot of work this year, and I couldn't be more proud of them. We have three seniors in the group this year. Alex Pierce on alto saxophone. Go ahead, wait, stand. Kerwin Bongers on trumpet. And Lindsay Prohaska in percussion. A let's have one more round of applause for Mrs. Hines and the 5th and 6th grade band. Thank you to the track team that set up the mats and chairs tonight. They get a track team. Thank you also to Mr. Eldridge for running the stream in the back. Appreciate that. Just as a reminder, if your student is signed up for high school band next year, there will be a very, very, very short parent meeting in the band room across the hall right afterwards. Should not take very long. Red Giant is about an exploding star, so I thought I'd leave you with a little bit of excitement. Red Giant. Thank you for coming. Drive safe. The parents' meeting will be just in the band room across the hall.